What's up, guys? This video is going to be in my top three favorite assault rifles, battle rifles. That style, semi-automatics, you know, what most people consider assault rifles. Anyway, start off, all these guns are loaded. They've been safety checked, and they are loaded. I keep all my guns in my safe. All my guns, period, are loaded, because when I need them, I want to be ready. There's nothing in the chambers, but I'm going to treat them as they are anyway. Guns just don't go off by themselves. And if you can't manipulate a loaded gun, you don't need a gun. Because that's gun safety in general. Anyway, up top is a Springfield M1A. It's the military, but the civilian version is called an M1A. The military version is an M14. M20, they have different versions, sniper rifle style. When I say sniper rifle style, it's just scoped and, you know, set up for that kind of more accurateized versions. The EBRs, you know, there's lots of different versions. They got the SOCOM shorter versions. This shoots a 7.62 by 51 NATO, 308 Winchester. This was the rifle before the M16. It's pretty much exactly the same rifle as the Grand Action, as the M1 Grand. Has the Grand Action, except for it was made better. I mean, M1 Grand's M1 Grand. It don't get much better than that, but this one does carry more rounds. Magazines are good. They hold 20-round magazines. That's just a 10-rounder in there now. I haven't got the 20-rounders yet. I got them all ordered a few more days. Matter of fact, should be shipped out tomorrow. But anyway, the gas system, I heard, was upgraded. And it was redesigned for the more accurate, lighter 308 round, or cartridge, or whatever, if you want to get technical. You can get these in walnut. I got this stock, this is synthetic, because it's lighter. The rubber butt, it's got a rubber butt pad on it. The recoil really isn't that bad. It's not much more than AK-47 if you've shot one. But anyway, if it walks on this earth, if it two legs or four legs, it can kill it. I'd say take down an elephant, no problem with proper shot placement. It's 308's a bad round, and you would have no problem with bear, grizzlies, at all. But anyway, I mean, most people prefer a larger round, but it will do the job. One of my reasons why this is one of my top favorite rifles is because where the AK-47 and the 223, you know, AR-15 platforms, just they won't reach the 500 yards and plus. This is going to be what you need right here. It's very accurate. People use them as sniper rifles in law enforcement, and pretty much when you're not going to go bolt action rifles and you need a semi-automatic capability, you're not going to have the supreme accuracy of a bolt action, but this is about as close as you're going to get. Of course, the sky's the limit on the accuracy you want of this gun. I just got a standard M1A, but you can get them. I've heard you can get them sub half MOA rifles if you want to put the money into them. And there's different versions, like Fulton Armory. I heard they make good ones, and there's some other versions. But anyway, that is a needed rifle. It's got its special role. That's why it's still used in the military today. That's why they still bring it out in each Army branch from time to time. It's still used in Iraq and Afghanistan, or, you know, every country we're serving, there's units that use these. But anyway, the AK-47, technically it's AKM, but this is an arsenal, so I've heard some people call it AK-103. I'm not really sure about that because the gas system's got a slightly different canto. But anyway, I'm not going into that. It's AK-47, AKM. They're all the same. They all run very accurate, very reliable, very durable, very tough guns. As a matter of fact, I consider this the best rifle ever made. Just my opinion. The accuracy is decent enough. Most, 200 to 300 yards, it's very accurate. A 2-inch group isn't bad. You aim for somebody's nose, you hit them in the forehead, the mission's job done. I've had some AKs are more accurate than others. I've had some that do 1-inch groups. But the main problem is the sight radius in it. That's where it kind of loses its. If it had a longer sight radius, but you can do things to make the AK more accurate. You can add optics and everything like that with the side mounted rails and everything like that. But anyway, I consider it the most reliable semi-automatic rifle ever made. I've seen them torture tested. I've heard, people, there's people swear by the Garands and everything like that. I don't know exactly, but I would put this gun up against any other gun for a reliability test. Okay, every gun's gonna have its lemons, but as far as average amount of rifles being resilient, AK-47 platforms, AKMs, AKSs, that's the side folding versions, these are gonna be the most reliable. Only problems I've ever seen them is with drum magazines. I've seen them. I've never had problems with Romanians. That's me. I know some older Wasser 10 or Wassers had some problems. I had a Wasser. It ran fine. My father's had about three Wassers. He's had Mac 90s. All of them. Every single one of them never had a problem. Matter of fact, one of them I had to kick the bolt open. It was rusted shut where it was just stuck on a wall for so long, and moisture got to it, and it ran fine. Anyway, that's why that fits in my. Plus, it's got a lot of knockdown compared to a 223. AK-47 will get the job done. Then you got your AR-15 platform rifle. This M4 carbine, whatever you want to call it, M4 because it's not got the technical specs or whatever. But this is a Stag Arms. By the way, the arsenal is built on is made in Russia, so it's technically about as close as you get now to a real Russian AK besides buying a used one. But the AR-15 is a Stag Arms. I've been shooting AR-15s. I've shot a lot of buddies' AR-15s for years now. I've shot two or three DPMSs, Rock River, Colt. A couple, including mine, two Stags. I can't. My buddy's got an LWRC. Anyway, I've shot quite a few, and he's got a. Let's see, LMT, I think. Yeah, he's also got an LMT. But anyway, he's got the true 10-inch barrel SBR version. This they're I've never had a malfunction with any of them. Believe it or not, they said none of them's ever had malfunctions. Some of them even shoot steel ammo. I've never shot steel ammo through them, but these rifles have been critiqued so much. I mean, every single thing from the barrel, the steel, every single type of steel, buffer tubes, pistol grips, the type of alloy, every single thing is broken down scientifically. And it's been tested for, I don't know, 30, 40 years now, to where just go on some AR15.com and look at some of the forums. They are technical. They are. I don't think there's any other gun made that's more technically look more technically. What's it called? Critiqued than the AR15. But the main reason why it's fits in there is because it's modular. It's easy to attach lights to. It's accurate. It's reliable, especially since the P mags. I do recommend getting P mags because they are very reliable magazines. They're durable. A lot of special units in the Army use it. I have a buddy who's Special Forces. That's all he uses is P mags. You can't see it, but on the other side, I do have a Caleres XT10 lights, 500 or 480 lumens. I don't know. It's way up there. I can't remember, but lights are good when you need them. If you need one, don't have one, you're screwed. But they can also give away. But you can add optics to them easy. It's got the flip ups, the Midwest Industry rears. Sky's the limit, man, with these rifles. It's just they're all three of these are just my main three. Sorry for the video being so long, but just some of my reasons of taking them in my top three rifle. All right, thanks, guys.